secure from all alarms. Leaning on the everlasting arms. What a fellowship, what a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine.
Hello, hello.
Leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning
on the everlasting arms.
And secure from all.
From my favorite country musician, Kenny Rogers. Hello, 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 Shiro. Nimekuona.
The everlasting.
Joki Neema. Patrick Favored Paul. God bless you. Karibuni sana. Henry Moya, karibu.
Leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning,
Shiko Irongo, karibu sana.
Leaning
on the everlasting arms. I hope you are home.
What a fellowship.
Masaya kafi imefika.
What a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness.
What a blessedness.
What a peace is mine.
What a peace is mine.
Leaning on the everlasting arms.
Pole kwa wale hamjazoea kuwa nyumbani wakati kama huu. Hii kafyu itaisha. Stay safe. Wash your hands so that we can fight this corona together. Mwehaki, karibu sana. Kafura, I can see you. Shiroa Stanri. Elizabeth Wamoni. Karibuni sana. I hope you are keeping safe. Edwin Nyaga. God bless you. Yes. So today we are having our fifth devotion, and we have been looking at Psalm 103. For those of you who are joining us today for the first time, you can follow the rest of the devotions on my on this page. They are there. And I want to believe that you are okay and that God has been gracious to you. And I hope you have not met with the men and women in uniform. And I hope that you have not met with the coronavirus. Hii kitu bado inaendelea. Hii kitu bado iko serious, my friend. Imesikia ni 38 sasa. 38 people. One has already succumbed. And so we need to be very, very, very serious with this coronavirus. I was looking at the news about Italy. Today, again, they had a very high number. They are almost hitting 1,000 a day. 1,000 deaths. That is not easy. So, Ukisikia tunaambiwa tujihadhari na hii kitu, tusichukulie kwa mzaha. This thing is serious. And we need to keep praying and to keep hoping. So, today is Saturday. Sitaki kuwaweka sana. Najua kesho ni siku ya ibada. Hata kama ibada tutakuwa nayo papa hapa. Hakuna kwenda kanisani. So I hope that you'll be able to be joining me tomorrow. From about 10 o'clock, we are going to stream our services here. And I trust that we will be joining you tomorrow. So today, for today's devotion, I will be brief. But as usual, we are going to do a song. I'll do one song. And then I will look at the fifth benefit of having a relationship with God. Fifth benefit of having a relationship with God. So today's song is a Swahili one, Nilipoona Chemchemi. When I saw the cleansing. La 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 Nilipoona chemchemi ya kuosha makosa, nilimsikia roho akiniambia njoo, namsifu namsifu aliyenifilia, njooni msifuni nyote kwa damu itusafishayo. So, Psalm 103 verses 1 to 5. And today we are looking at the fifth benefit of a relationship with God. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities, that is number one. Who heals all your diseases, that is number two. Who redeems your life from destruction, that is number three. Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies, that is number four, and that is what we were considering yesterday. And then today, in verse 5, who satisfies your mouth with good things. Who satisfies your mouth with good things. Now, we have a God who satisfies. And that is the benefit that we would like to consider this evening. That God, in his grace and mercies, does not withhold anything that is good from us. But he satisfies us. And it is only God who can truly satisfy. The question is, do you have satisfaction in your life? Are you satisfied with the way things are? Have you ever gone to a shop, picked a shoe or a dress, particularly for ladies here? And you really thought that it would satisfy you only to go home, test it, put it on, and then return it to its shopping bag, and you have never worn it again. It did not satisfy you. You see, in our spiritual lives, we have this longing to be satisfied. But does God satisfy you? The longing of your heart, is it deeply satisfied? We are living at a time when we cannot even go to church. So if you have been finding going to church as your sort of source of satisfaction, then you agree with me that you are in deep trouble. You must train yourself to have a relationship with God, because it is only that relationship with God that will give you satisfaction at a time like this when you cannot even congregate with others. And so the psalmist is telling himself, because this is David talking to himself. And by the way, did you know that it is okay to talk to yourself? Yeah, it is okay. You can talk to yourself. And so, that is the essence of meditation. What is meditation? Meditation is talking to yourself without necessarily verbalizing. And I saw somewhere on social media that the Psychiatrists Association of some place has issued a notice that it is okay during quarantine to talk to the plants and to the pets in your house. And this particular one was very interesting. It said you can speak to the pots and to the plants in your house without being necessarily a nutcase. You are not a nutcase if you do that. And it said that you only call for help if any of the pots or the plants in your house respond to your talking to them. So in other words, David is having a meditation of his heart. And during his time of meditation, he remembers the benefits of the Lord over and over and over. He remembers that it is God who forgives him his sins. He remembers that it is God who has healed him in times past when he was sick. He remembers that it was God who redeemed him from destruction. He remembered it was God who was gracious to him, dealing with him not according to his sin. And then he remembered that the life that he had, all the satisfaction that he got satisfaction not from the things that he had, but he got satisfaction from a relationship with God. And so this evening, I implore you, during these times of shutdown and curfews and lockdowns and stay home and social distancing, I implore you, my friend, it is time you got closer to God. It is time you re-established a relationship with God. And one of the things that this lockdown is doing to all of us is that we are being reset to factory settings, so to speak. We are being taken back to humanity, so that finally we can be able to confront ourselves. Because in the hustle and bustle of hustling and looking for wealth and working and doing all manner of things, we have been too fast. Now we have slowed down. It is time to listen to that inner voice that tells you, you are created for a purpose. So may God bless us. May God bless all of us. And this evening, let us say a special prayer, remembering the people who are working in the medical profession, our doctors, our nurses. And so as part of showing solidarity with the people that work in the medical profession, and who are in the front line in the fight against this COVID-19, it is important that you go, you can pen the name of a doctor, the name of a nurse, the name of a pharmacist, the name of somebody who's working in the medical profession. Because really, those are people who are really, really very exposed. And we would like to remember them and pray for them by name. And so if you could be able to text them, we are going to remember them in a special way here. So if you have somebody that you would like us to remember, remember yesterday I told you that today we are going to have a short interaction. So one of the things that I would like us to interact with is, do you have somebody that you would like to remember in prayer? Somebody in the medical profession, somebody who is offering healthcare services. It will be nice to remember them. And so if you can text their name, I will be able to see them and I will be able to remember them personally as we mention them before the Lord in prayer. So if you have such people, let us continue to remember them. Let us also continue to remember those people who have continued to be positive on this coronavirus thing. 38 in number, one has succumbed. So we have 37 people who are ill and we need to remember them in prayer. We have other people who are being tested as we speak, and we want to pray that the Lord is going to come through for them. And so, hii kitu, isipokuwa ni Mungu akuje yeye mwenyewe, atusaidie. We need the intervention of God. Because it is God who can be able to put a hold on this thing. Hii kitu sio mchezo. Namjua ya kwamba, by the way, you know the West is struggling with their own issues of corona. And so they have no time for Africa. And if you have had time to watch the international news channels, they are reporting very little on Africa. So sahi, hii kitu ni yetu. Na hii kitu ni sisi wenyewe tutajisort. Because everybody is dealing with their own issues. And so my friend, it is up to you and me to do what we must do to keep this thing at bay. And so, if you are there, I would like us to say a prayer to those people, those of our brothers and sisters who are working in this front line, so that the Lord can remember them. Okay, so I can see that somebody wants us to remember her sister, Hannah Irongo. Thank you very much. Anybody else out there? We remember Wangeshi in the US. God bless you. We remember Sarah Kamurwa. We remember Koindegwa. We remember Mombi Gadhura. All these people are the people that we know. And we continue to commit them before God in prayer as they continue being in the front line. The second category of people that I would like us to remember are the people who are in the security forces, the people who are enforcing the curfew in this land. We pray that the Lord is going to grant them wisdom. The Lord is going to watch over them also as they keep law and order. And we are sad for the people that were clobbered last night. And we pray that the Lord is going to be gracious and that is not going to happen again. So may the Lord bless us and may the Lord give us a time to reflect on his goodness and a time to know that he is the one who gives us true satisfaction. Let us pray. We bow before your presence, Lord, and we thank you because of this day. We want to pray for those people who have continued to test positive to the coronavirus in this country. And we pray that you remember them and remember their families at this time of anguish. And because you are the wonderful healer, we pray that you may reach out to them. And we pray that, Lord, you may touch them with your healing hand. We continue to pray for the doctors and the nurses. Some of them are so close to us, they are family. And we pray that, Lord, you may reach out to them and bless them to the glory and to the honor of your name as they give themselves to this life-saving activity. Oh God, we pray that you will watch over them and protect them so that in saving the lives they may not be endangered themselves. We thank you because of this country, and we thank you because of the time that we have been given a curfew to stay indoors. And we pray that, Lord, this pandemic is going to be sorted out by you, O God, because only you can help us. We pray for the community of nations. There are people who are suffering more than we are. In particular, I want to remember Italy, where people keep on dying from the coronavirus. And there is a cloud of darkness and gloom and mourning and heaviness upon that land. We pray that even as we ask you to remember us here in Kenya, we in particular want to pray for Italy, that seems to be so hard hit by this virus. So be together with us and bless us, for we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. So thank you very much. It has been a pleasure to have you, and we hope to have you tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning. We are going to have a service together. We are going to share the word of God together, encourage one another. We are going to pray for one another. Ikoguorushio mada inya. Tomorrow we are not going to have the evening service, evening devotion. We are going to have the Sunday morning service. Koguo, roshio da inya. Ukiretene. Unyue shai. Kahora. Da inya shia kinya. Ingia kwa mtadao. Utatupata. If you are not able to find us there live, then we are going to post the recording later. So you can always follow us. Asante sana from wherever you are joining us from, and from wherever you are listening to me from. We are praying for you as a church. Even though we are not meeting together, bado tunaendelea kuwaombea na bado tunaendelea kupambana na hii corona tukiwa kwa pamoja. Na kwa hivyo, keep washing your hands. Yes, so that we can deal with this thing. Keep staying indoors if you must. Only go out when it is absolutely, absolutely necessary. And like I said yesterday, tulisema uchukue karatasi, uandike kwa maandishi makubwa, na uiweke kwa mlango yako ya kutoka nje upande wa ndani. Uandike, outside there is coronavirus. So that every time you are stepping out of the door, you can look at that notice and know that out there is coronavirus, and everyone is a suspect. Everyone, including your closest neighbor at home, they are all suspect. We are all suspect. So don't entertain anyone. Is your wakati wa kuentertain watu? Kila mtu wakae kwao. You can send help if help is needed. But this is not time for visiting. This is time for sitting down in your house, waiting upon the Lord. Na tena hii sio wakati wa kubabaika sana. Hapana. It is time to keep calm and keep praying. And if the news are too depressing for you, switch off the TV. You don't have, the world is not stopping because you are not watching. No. You can turn off that TV. You don't have to keep getting this bad news. Yes. So, God bless you. See you tomorrow. Narushio todo ni mwakigwa ni wakanitha. Rushio ni mukahotha. Umothe dilamweti ya kedu. No, rushio ni mukakehotha. Na ukiririkane ati. Kanitha oneo yanyu thiaga. It is still has bills to pay. So tomorrow, last Sunday, I know many of you did not give your offering. But tomorrow, remember to send your offering to your church. Yes, there are still bills to be paid. So ukae vizuri, uogee vizuri na watu wako, na pole sana kwa wazee ambao hawajazoea kukaa kwa nyumba wakati kama huu na masaa kama haya, and particularly on a Saturday evening. And so God bless you. See you tomorrow. And it is always nice to see you in these streets of Facebook. Ndarikia. Leo ni uguo. Murathimwo na mukome wega na Mwathani amukinyirie utugi wake. We are going to call it a day now.